Blessed are all who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. By the labor of your hands you shall eat. Blessed are you, and blessed will you be. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, creator of all things, who laid down for the human race the law of work, graciously grant that by the example of Saint Joseph, and under his patronage, we may complete the works you set us to do, and attain the rewards you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, over all these things put on love, that is, the bond of perfection, and let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful, and whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Whatever you do, do from the heart, as for the Lord and not for men, knowing that you will receive from the Lord the due payment of the inheritance. Be slaves of the Lord Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, give success to the work of our hands.
Lord, give success to the work of our hands.
Before the mountains were begotten and the earth and the world were brought forth, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God.
Lord, give success to the work of our hands.
You turn men back to dust, saying, "Return, O children of men." For 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night.
Lord, give success to the work of our hands.
Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants.
Lord, give success to the work of our hands.
Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days. Let your work be seen by your servants, and your glory by their children.
Lord, give success to the work of our hands.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus came to his native place and taught the people in their synagogue. They were astonished and said, "Where did this man get such wisdom and mighty deeds? Is he not the carpenter's son? Is not his mother named Mary, and his brothers James, Joseph, Simon, and Judas? Are not his sisters all with us? Where did this man get all this?" And they took offense at him. But Jesus said to them, "A prophet is not without honor, except in his native place and in his own house." cannot work many mighty deeds there because of their lack of faith. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. This feast of Saint Joseph the Worker gives us a moment in the church's year to pause and to give thanks for the Lord's gift of work to us. It's so easy in our lives to take for granted that which we do, the work that we partake in. Especially in the midst of this time of pandemic, it can be sometimes a burden to us, but as well, hopefully we're beginning to realize the gift that we have in the work that we do. Especially given that many are out of work or are struggling to find that in their lives. It gives us a chance to pause and to truly be grateful for something that perhaps we've taken for granted in the midst of our lives. Our Judeo-Christian culture sees in work something which is supremely good. Not just something that is to be taken for granted, not just something that we experience as toil. Certainly after the fall, it is more burdensome to us. But work, the idea of cultivating the ground, was a gift that was given to man even in the Garden of Paradise. That it was truly from the beginning God's plan to instill in us a participation in creation. So really, no matter what it is that we do, no matter what job we play or role we take in society, we are doing that work of cultivating, of partaking in the Lord's gift of creation, of spending ourselves for the sake and the glory of God. St. Paul, though, reminds us of a calling which lies beyond our work. An aim, if you will, that all of our work should be directed towards. He says, "Brothers and sisters, over all things, put on love." We as Christians, our work as Christians, everything that we do in this world as Christians should be identified by love. People should be able to look at us and to see the way that we love differently because we know Jesus Christ. That is our work in this world, and that is the work that we see Saint Joseph doing throughout his life. And so today, if we desire to give fitting honor to Saint Joseph, we desire to praise God through the intercession of such a great man, we will heed the words of St. Paul, "Over all things, to put on love." Let us turn now to our Heavenly Father and offer him our prayers and petitions.
That all of us may be nourished and transformed by Christ in the Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the word of God may put an end to violence in the name of religion between nations and peoples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That persecuted Christians throughout the world may be protected by God within their homes and churches, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us may be led by Jesus into deeper communion with him during this Easter season, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those affected by the coronavirus, for the sick, that God may heal them and bring them peace, for those working to find cures, that God will guide them in his wisdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our deceased loved ones may feast forever with Christ at his heavenly banquet, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we praise you on this feast day of St. Joseph the Worker. We ask that you would grant us joy in our work and perseverance always in the bond of charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, fount of all mercy, look upon our offerings which we bring before your majesty in commemoration of Saint Joseph, and mercifully grant that the gifts we offer may become the means of protection for those who call upon you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and on the commemoration of Saint Joseph, to give you fitting praise, to glorify you and bless you. For this just man was given by you as spouse to the Virgin Mother of God, and set as a wise and faithful servant in charge of your household, to watch like a father over your only begotten Son, who was conceived by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord, giving thanks to God through him. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Together we offer our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Having fed upon heavenly delights, we humbly ask you, O Lord, that by St. Joseph's example, cherishing in our hearts the signs of your love, we may ever enjoy the fruit of perpetual peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who wander about the world seeking the ruin of souls.